Okay, it's May 19th at 7:47 a.m. Come on. Gotta let these little heathens out. They hear everything outside. Alright. It's Tuesday. So, ow! Damn it. All the clover, because we can't cut the grass, because it's soaking wet the ground still. Real quick one, because I'm not going to do all the gardening, just give you every single thing that's here and there, because that gets boring, and I'm sure most of you will get sick and roll your eyes. The sunflowers out here, surprisingly, these are about 12 inches tall. On the east end here. And then there's a couple that are small. Again, these are all from the same batch of seeds. Those are small. Those are about 8 inches, about 14 inches, and so forth. Then you got your purple hull peas, the first three, and that one right there in the back there. There's like three of them in there. The peas, sweet peas are growing pretty good. Black-eyed peas in that second row. Second row. Right back there. All of those are growing really good. Except for, again, the second one. I don't know why. Just like the sweet pea right here is not growing. But look at the broccoli here. Got flower on it too already. This is one of the first four broccoli I planted out here. Got this string here for the beans, the peas that Brian on. But I got the broccoli there. And I just planted this one and this one. That one. I'm not sure that's the broccoli or if it's different. Zucchini is coming out. This one here, this is the Black Beauty, I think it is. It's either Black Beauty or the gold one. It's already about 5 feet almost out of the garden. But you look at how they're all sprung up. Step over it. Look at that. They're getting that little virus, fungus under there. I use a quarter cup or a half cup of baking soda and filtered water. Just as an extra precaution. And I've been spraying them. Now here's the other set of broccoli I put out about 10 days after the first set. Look at all four of these are up. Look how big that one is. That one's bigger than the first one down there in the corner. It's not flowered yet. But that one right there. Put this kind of like, I can't see on this viewfinder with the crack, but that's about 10 inches, almost 12 inches above the ground right there. And then this one here is just a little bit small. It's like the daddy bear, the mama bear, and the baby bear, but then there's the other baby bear. We got two watermelons coming up. One there, watermelon. And honeydew melons, that's like cantaloupe, basically one there. And I reseeded that one and it's growing up. Where is it at now? Again, I can't see on this damn viewfinder, so. Right there, that's the other honeydew. And then we got the beans. See, now look at this, is the other sunflowers I was talking about. Look at how big these are. These are like 2 feet tall. These are like bushy and everything. I know I dropped seeds together. I didn't mean to make them so close, but you know, it's like a little fence it's going to make. See, like this. See, and again, same thing. Look how these are tall right here in this middle part. A couple small ones. Then look at the tall right there. It goes right into the zucchini. That bean right there, I believe, is... I'm going to say it's a white bean. I don't know for sure, but I mean, I don't have any white beans, northern beans. Well, we do, but not with stuff out of the store. Cucumber, spraying the same disease mix on it because it looks like it's catching the same type of fungus on it. I planted straight eight seeds, one there and one in the back. You can't see it. Right back there in that opening in the middle there. You can barely see it with this crack. Okay, this one. Then I came out here last night with string and I added two more poles here. Tomato stakes here. And right there at the end, and then I tied strings, and I got like a little fence for them to crawl on because I stopped there and look at all this coming up here. These are all that canela runner bean. Italian rudder bean. See, nothing going on there except grass. I'm gonna have to pull all that out here, but I can do that later or whatever. Because we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 canela beans growing here, which would be more than enough for 5 people. And we got 2 people. Okay, let's see, I gotta use that. See that runner right down there? I don't know if you can see it. I can't see it on the screen. It's running out here. It's turned around and twisted. Anyway, I gotta take that and wrap it around some string to have it come back this way. The okra, we had, what is it, 8? And 8 is what? 16, 16, 16, 32. So we had 32 places. We have 28 growing. And, but there's like 2 in one spot. Like right there is a double. There's another one right down there. Let's see if I can find it in here. Right there, I think it is. Yeah, that's a double. And I thought one more right there. Again, I can't see on the viewfinder very well there. Okay, we got green pod, okra. Then we got burgundy okra in the center two. The center two 16 plant spots are burgundy. And then a long pod or spineless mixed together. I planted peanuts. They suggest that you put 4 peanuts in a hole for each plant. I did that about a week ago. And you can see how that one looks, right? One that's on there, what is that? Right there, right there. That's the peanut plant. This is the other one. This is the second one that's got 4 in there. And that's come up. Now the other two still, nothing is coming up yet at all. That's kind of getting a little frustrating when I get stuff like this. Because everything is planted exactly the same. I put the little bit of 15, 15, 15 fertilizer in there. I put planting soil with lime that's mixed in there really well. It's not a lot. It's not overpowering to help neutralize the pH in the soil. And you see those 2 down there grow really good, and then all of a sudden there's 2 nothing. You see all this okra come up, and then you got none there. I can't, again, with the sun now, I can't see it at all. But there's a hole there. There's a hole somewhere in there. There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Wait, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 of 32 is not growing. At least I can see right up the sun. So that's going with that. This torch sunflowers look like this. Now I know when I was a kid, I see stuff like this wild. Well, that's a torch sunflower. I thought it was a wild weed. Those big leaves are really nice looking. This would be something I'd rather use next year to border the garden. I'll put majority of it torch sunflowers all the way around and use the Titan sunflowers as like a little extra filling with it. But these torch ones look much better, much shade, more shadier, like almost like a little tree. And we got more zucchini here, which I sprayed with that baking soda water mix for fungus to make sure I get that off. Because look at the tomatillos here. Now, let me zoom in if I can. Yeah, where is that right there? You can see the spots on it and everything. Rather than taking a chance waiting to see, I just went ahead and sprayed the baking soda water mix on there to get that stuff. It won't, shouldn't hurt it, but it might take care of that fungus. But you can see that's 4 feet tall, first time at all. And the other one right behind is right, like I'd say about 3.5 feet in the cage. I was going to do 2 more, but now I'm looking at how space is starting to become limited a little bit. Might put one in between the edge of the garden here and that zucchini. See, now the zucchinis are running north. Have to take and move it over that way. Because we got 2 going out there. You can see them leading almost to the end. See, now it's going to get to a point where next year, no better, too. We'll put like maybe 2 zucchini, like real close to each other. One right here. And one right a little bit forward, just not much more, but off to the side. And then we'll do like 6 or 8 like that. And that'll be it, because right now we got like 15 or so. I don't even know what's over there, 11, I think, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16 zucchini out here. And about 8 is all you need. Now there's one right there we just transplanted. Where is it? Right there, we just transplanted out of a pot. And it took really well, you know, it's healthy, but it's not, it's been about 4 or 5 days also. Now these are all runner beans here, the canela runner beans, that one, That one, again, I can't see it. That one, right there. One somewhere in there. God, I can't see anything on here. And then one over here. I don't know if you're looking at it. But there's a space right there. It's the only thing that's not growing. So there's two in one of these, I believe. But anyway, that's what we have. These hummingbird feeders up here on these plant hooks. And I put four rows of string. It's going about 24 feet across for them to attach onto and grow. That's why I got all them string in the back there too. That's gonna be fun. There's not, you know, they're not gonna go. We're gonna try to train them to go that way, but we don't know for sure they're gonna do that. I put my Swiss chard. I've had that since last year, early last year. And it survived and survived, and I finally said, I'm gonna put it out here in the garden, and that's the condition. I took off a couple of leaves on the bottom that were dead yesterday. But we'll see how well that goes. It should do well. And my first tomato we had is right here. I followed off of a YouTube video where the lady said, put like a little toilet paper center thing around to keep some bugs off it and whatnot. And today I just put the tomato stake in there. Very carefully, I didn't want to break the root system up. Put in there, and it's taken up pretty well. So today is Tuesday. We'll wait till like Friday or Saturday and come out here and do this again, instead of every other day like I was doing. So that tomato right there is about 5 inches up out of the ground. I got that toilet paper holder down in there about 3/4. So that's the gardens, and just wanted to do that real quickly.